The Inspector General of Police, Mohamed Adamu, has confirmed that the training for the newly created Special Weapons and Tactics Team, SWAT, will begin today. Adamu also listed the qualifications of officers to be trained in the new police tactical team to replace the disbanded Special Anti-Robbery Squad, SARS. The IGP, in a statement signed by the force public relations officer, Frank Mba, insisted no ex-SARS operatives were shortlisted in the SWAT team. According to him, the officers selected for the training are young, smart, and energetic officers who have acquired not less than 7 years working experience with clean service records. Other criteria include no pending disciplinary matters, no record of violation of rights of citizens or misuse of firearms, and are physically fit to withstand the rigor of SWAT training and operations. Joining us live is Roy Okidevie, a National PRO Association of Licensed Private Security Practitioners of Nigeria. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you. It's always a pleasure.
Reports coming from the Nigerian police says the training begins today. Do you see this as rushing the process? Do you think the police might be moving too fast?
Well, you know, it is good to move very fast, but what direction are you moving to? You know, that's why we always get skeptical when there's a crisis and the government rushes into trying to provide solutions. I've said it many times. One of the things that they have looked into now, they said the officers that are selected must have served 7 years in service. How many officers would you get nationwide to be positioned in different states? Let's say you want to start with states that have major crises right now for criminal issues. You will be having close to 20 states. So how can you set up that structure in 20 states and you are going to get officers that have served 7 years without any criminal record, without any other issues, and they will pass the course? Then the other issue I have now is, what is the content of this training that is different from the one you had before? Can we look at it? Can we interrogate it? Can we discuss about the content? Who are those that are called? You said the International Red Cross. Thank you. And other people which we are not known. If it is a crisis situation, I always advise, we have the IROC, you dissolve it. We have the CTU, you dissolve it. So many other units have been dissolved or scrapped or suspended. Why can't you fall back to your immediate structure as an alternative to hasty decision? Why can't you say, okay, can we use the structure on ground? Can we use the mobile police to intervene? Can we use the regular police to investigate? Can we use this money we want to put into this hasty training now to begin to recruit graduates? I've said this thing many times. If you go to UNILAG, you go to UI, go to Open University, you will see a lot of Nigerian youth, these youth that are in the street, that can also communicate and interrogate the actions of their colleagues. They are ready to work for the police, and they are reading graduate courses in criminology, in security and intelligence. And they are open, they are in the streets riding Okada and doing all sorts of things like barbing saloon and all that. Can we take up this quantity of youth in this quest for peace right now? Can we put them in these training schools? Can we begin to train them towards the SWAT that we want to have, graduates that have graduated 4 years in reading security intelligence, security and communication? Once you have that running, then you use what you have now to begin to conclude on cases on ground and improve the curriculum. Let me tell you something. The training school that you are using for the SWAT, did you just build this yesterday? Is it not the same training school that we have grouses about? Okay, what is the relationship also with the private practitioners that you said you want to involve in the training? I'm a member of almost all the security private practice in Nigeria and diaspora. Which of them have you approached with a blueprint to say XYZ members from your committee should come with me to interrogate this training curriculum?
All right, hold on, Mr. Okidevia.
Can you help us for personnel for training?
Kindly hold on. I want to also ask about weapons and equipment and remuneration. There's a lot of other factors that I believe are important with regard to setting up a new team and force moving in a different direction. How do you think that they must bring all of this together, aside, you know, just training?
You see, if we want to have a SWAT team by global standard, we should be beating global standard, because the SWAT teams we have in diaspora that we want to copy, they don't have the complications that we have in Nigeria and Africa. They don't have this challenge of data management. They don't have this challenge of technological input in their activities. They don't trust their system. They trust their system less than the way we can trust our system, the judiciary system, the laws that we have, the effectiveness of the laws. Then government compromise at every level. A local government chairman, a councillor, a state governor can easily call any DPO, any police, just to communicate complications in a case. Now, if we look at the training of the personnel and it's coming out, does he have a medical cover? Does he have insurance? Is his document telling him that two or three of your children are going to be trained by government? Is that same document telling him that you have a vehicle to operate on with fueling and you don't need to generate money to repair your vehicle? You have a communication line to escalate if any of your bosses want you to raise money for them. Because one of the issues we have now is police officers saying, the guy is saying we should bring feedback. So we need all of those things in place, like you rightly said. What kind of technological input? The whole of Nigeria, it was only Abba Kyari and his team that could track people that have eloped people's money, people that are committing kidnapping and crime. So how many type of this equipment do you want to institute in different parts of the country to be used by this personnel? Will they be trained in that expertise? Will they have the expertise to exploit developmental skills in technology? Do they have communication with global technology platforms that when it's time for an upgrade, they will know that it's time for an upgrade? So we need to look at all of that.
Roy Okidevia, thank you so much for speaking with us. Always interesting getting your views on these topics. Looking forward to another conversation.
Always a pleasure.
Hello. Hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.